On this Valentine's Day, I will tell you a story of love that in true guy form includes blood and action. This is the history of the Battle Angel Alita franchise. In 1990, Kodansha Comics released the first volume of the Battle Angel Alita manga. The series, created by Yukito Kishiro, follows the story of Alita, a cyborg found in the scrapyard near the floating city of Zalem by Dr. Ido. While she has no memory of her former life, Alita discovers that she has incredible fighting skills. Deciding to use these for good, Alita joins Ido in the fight against crime as a hunter-warrior. While getting used to her new surroundings of Junkyard City, Alita befriends and falls in love with a young man named Hugo, whose only dream is to go and live in Zalem, and is willing to get there at any cost necessary. 3 years after the manga was published, ADV Films released an anime adaptation which covered the first two volumes of the manga. This anime was rated R for its graphic violence, use of blood, and sexual scenes. Only two episodes were made. According to the manga creator Kishiro, he was too busy with the manga to review the plan coolly and was never actually very serious about an anime adaptation. In the 90s, James Cameron wrote a script for a live-action adaptation. At the time, he chose between making Alita and Avatar, and as we know, went with the latter. The project went into development hell until Robert Rodriguez began to push for the project. With an interview with Collider.com, a movie news source, Rodriguez stated that he went to Cameron and asked him about the script. Cameron told him that, "If you can finish the script, I'll produce it and you can direct it." The reason the film hasn't come out until recently is because of the technology needed to bring Alita to life didn't exist until now. This film has several challenges that it's going to have to overcome, the biggest being the history of bad anime adaptations. The two biggest offenders of this are Dragon Ball Evolution and Ghost in the Shell. Both of these are hated by fans of the anime and have been cited as whitewashing their characters. They were also not well received by critics. There is also the film's rating. Instead of being R, like the anime, the film will be PG-13, rating what it can show. There's also Alita's anime eyes, which some people have stated either falls into the uncanny valley or is straight up ridiculous. Despite its challenges, there are some pros. Having worked on Avatar, James Cameron knows how to use CGI. And having directed Sin City, Robert Rodriguez has proven himself to be an experienced director. Ollie Barter of Forbes magazine pointed out that James Cameron knows the source material very well, having read the manga in the 90s, and also, this is a passion project for him, which means that there's going to be a lot of love put into this project. In his interview with Collider.com, Rodriguez stated that the film will be using limited green screens to ensure it stays grounded, and speaking on its rating, he said that when it's science fiction and cyborgs, you can get away with a lot. Which brings to the question of, should you see it? Well, I can't say that, because if I did, that'd make this a persuasive speech. However, I can tell you that it comes to theaters on July 20th under the title of Alita Battle Angel. The Alita franchise has gone through many different forms throughout the year, starting with the manga, to the anime, to the most recent adaptation. Whether or not this new adaptation will be good is up for time to tell. Because it's a passion project, I personally have some hope. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm off to go pre-order my ticket. Thank you.